Barakallah feek. And one of that time, that God should not be a limit. God is limitless. We don't say these words, because Allah, we believe in the hadda, which is separate Allah from His creation. That's why the brother Muhammad, wafaqahullah, when he was speaking to the guy, and he said this necessary being should be, I think he used limitless or something. He said, okay, is he in a tree? My man, he said to him, ايش قال له؟ قال له انا اتكلم عن الغود. انت مسلم ترى ايش العود في الشجر؟ So he because now stuck. When he said لا حد, okay, now, okay, if he said there's no حد, so it's everywhere, because حد mean he's timeless, I mean limitless. So therefore, everywhere. He's everywhere, inside and outside. Yeah. But we say, اثبات الحد. And the Salaf use the حد, that اثبات الحد لله, no, because we know Allah, how big, no. Only Allah knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala, himself. But to go and guess al-Jahmiya, wal-Mu'tazila, and al-Falasifa, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala separate from His creation. So barakallah for using that term, al-Had. And this book was written. So that's why my brothers, when the ulama of the Salaf won't and guess ilm al-Kalam bring doubt. You know, when you say God is partless, he should not be composed of parts. I said to Muhammad Hijab, in a private conversation, I said, if someone says Allah's hand, how are you going to explain Allah's hand? And he said, oh, is Allah's hand Allah's face? Is Allah's hand part of him, or is Allah as Allah? It's part of Allah's point, I mean, it's attributes. It's a real attribute. Okay, but you just told me God should be partless. That's why the term, when we say partless, what we say, Salaf, Al-Sunnah Jama'ah, we say, what do you mean by that? What do you mean? Because we don't speak with these terms. Partless, spaceless, timeless. No, we don't speak like that. The Quran speaks like that? No. The Quran, I mean, Allah said that in the Quran, no sunnah. So we say, for example, when we say Allah has a body, Jism. Yeah. We don't say yes or no. We say, okay, what do you mean by body? Are you saying Allah like His creation? Never. Or you mean that Allah has an essence? Allah has an essence, the way of His majesty? We accept that. However, we don't use this word body. We say that. Why? Because body has ambiguous term. That's why the Salaf, they were very, that's why Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahu ta'ala, when he was asked about the Quran, is the sawt makhluq? And al-Bukhari, rahimahu ta'ala, he said, the qira'at al-qari, makhluq? Al-Bukhari said makhluq. Tayyib, Imam Ahmad won't unguess this. Why Imam Ahmad, rahimahu ta'ala, won't unguess it? Because when you say the qira'ah, are you referring to the sawt or to the Quran? That's why you have to ask a person, what are you referring to? Are you referring to the voice of the reciter or that which he's reciting? You see, that's why the Salaf, rahimahumullah, and guess what? There was a philosopher, I forgot his name. He came way after. He said, many people fall into mistakes and errors because they do not clarify terms. Ibn Taymiyyah mentioned that years, 100 years before that. He noticed that the problem that Asha'ira, Maturidiyya, Al-Jahmiyyah fell into problems because they start accepting terms. Al-Jawhar, Al-Hayyiz, okay, if you say Allah is above His creation, meaning this direction, if it's a direction, meaning it's a space, if it's space, then it's Allah is above it, meaning Allah has a body, is a body. All of this, Ilzamat, akhi, where do you get this from? When he said, if you point up, mean is direction or okay, if it's direction, what do you mean by direction? And if it's space, what do you mean by space? Is it created or uncreated? We believe, like we said, my brother, Allah bless you, Allah above is the arsh and there's nothing above Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ar-Rahman, you know, alhamdulillah, ahl sunnah. That's why the problem that I have, because you say about Muhammad Hijab, the problem I have with brother is aqidah issue, akhi. Wallahi, aqidah, akhi. I never accused him. He accused people of zina, accused people of money, stealing money. I never done that to one of his friends or people or him. Never, because that's not deen. Because I know shari'atan, if you accuse someone with zina, four witnesses, you cannot say to a person, brother, there's someone said you, or to sister, you, someone said you done zina. Okay, master, what you have to do? You have to come forward, clarify yourself. No, the sister should say, akhi, wait. You have to bring a proof. To the Qadi, not online, not on Twitter, to the Qadi, four witnesses. If not, you got lashes. Then what? You're a kadab. We should not accept your testimony. You understand? So we have aqidah, akhi. It's not like the brother came to me and said, look, I spoke to brother Ali. He wants to reconcile. Akhi, this is not football to get him. This is deen, akhi. You lied, accuse people of that. Then I ask, bismillah. He uses this argument of God, it should not be parts composed with parts. What do you call it? Partless. Okay, this is not. This is what the Salaf want and guess. Imam Ahmed want and guess. Shafi'i want and guess. Abu Hanifa want and guess. Wallah, ilm al-kalam. Ikhwa, move aside. Afwan, afwan. Sorry, brother. Afwan, close. Assalamu alaikum. Aghlaq al-bab, habibi. I said, close the door. Back of they say, close the door. You have no door anyway. Do you understand, akhi? Alhamdulillah. So Ibn Taymiyyah, when he said that, there's a brother, mashallah, called Abu Fida, Hussein bin Mas'ud. He's a Salafi brother from Egypt, mashallah. He has a nice, even our Sheikh Abu Iyad, mashallah, as well. Spoke about it. When our Sheikh Abu Iyad written essays in advising Muhammad Hijab about this argument he's using, it's not because he wants to attack a brother. Mashallah, you see brother that is well spoken, giving da'wah, alhamdulillah, we do help them. I said, akhi, look, mashallah, you well spoken, but be careful this term, be careful with this. Here, take this, you know, take that. But if you are calling to yourself, you're going to take me as your enemy. Because why? Like, brothers corrected me. Some brothers said, akhi, you made a mistake in that. I said, okay. You understand?
Yeah.
I said, oh, okay. But if I'm calling to myself, if you correct me, I'm going to get angry. Because why? I believe I'm calling to myself.
Yeah.
You understand? So, ikhwa, this term, and like brother came here, you know, the argument of, you know, there's no problem to show that universe came to existence, yeah? No problem with that. However, the Asha'ira, the argument that they used to prove Allah's, to prove the universe came to, because the Asha'ira was their main target to refute the philosophers that the universe is eternal, is to prove the universe has existence. The way they did it is not according to Quran and Sunnah. They did it according to the false principles. That's why they negate a chain of events and in the past. You know that,
yeah.
They negate that because why? If they affirm that,
yeah.
Then they go, I guess the argument of the universe has a beginning.
Hawadith la awala,
limada? Event has no beginning. Not because Ibn Taymiyyah believes the matter is eternal with Allah. No. Because Allah, Allah al-awwal, la shay'a qablah. والله أول بإيش بأسمائه وصفاته وأفعاله not be careful from saying الله الأول وأسماؤه وصفاته that's a mistake you know no بأسمائه so if Allah is the first with his name's attribute الله فعال لما يريد وكان الله عزيزا حكيما وكان غفورا رحيما so there is many first Allah always So the ulama Ibn Qayyim and Ibn Taymiyyah, Ibn Abbas before the Sahaba, Ibn Ahmed, mean Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always exercise his actions. So when you say the first creation, what do you mean first creation? So are you saying before that Allah, because Allah has no beginning, was a static? Wa'iyadu billah? No. Allah does whatever he wishes. However, every creation that came into existence did not come from prior existence. It's not conditional, because Allah can bring something into existence and make it non-existent. You're blocking the brother I'm speaking
sorry.
To.
Oh, sorry.
You know, non-existent, you know.
Make him non-existent.
So, yeah, non-existent. You want to be
non-existent?
Non-existent. You know. This according to the atheist. Because
yeah.
Atheist, if you hide him, he doesn't exist anymore.
No,
you know, cause I cannot see him. But if I see him exist. So the point here, this issue, we need to study it. You know, like, you know, the brother was talking about how the universe came to exist because of this contagious argument.
Yeah.
That you know is not is independent. Hey, this actually, wallah is clear. The universe has a beginning. You can't negate that. There is matters that we don't see right now. It came to existence. That's what Ibn Taymiyyah said. If you say universe is eternal, define universe. Me, part of the universe. Tree, part of the universe. The clouds, part of the universe. But we see that me, I was not here all my life. I born not long ago. I don't want to say my age anyway. I know everyone's waiting for my age, but I wasn't born, you know, like, you understand? So clearly that we came into existence, and it's like fitri. But what happened when the Asha'ira and Jahmiya, they say, okay, we have to convince these people, so let us use their tools. But however, it's okay to learn ilm al-kalam, not for everyone, for a scholar who's mutamakkin, to refute them with it, to show them the contradiction of this argument they're using. Do you understand that? It's okay, that's what Ibn Taymiyyah spoke about. Shamsi Uthaymin mentioned that. Akhi, I know brothers, akhi, not one, not two. When they start learning philosophy in universities, one brother, I remember he called me, he said, akhi, it's a doubt in hadith, not in the Quran. Because remember, what is a shirk? skepticism. Who came with it first? The thing is, what's his name came with it first? It's Ghazali came. Skepticism, doubting everything. That's why Ghazali started doubting his the daruriyat. That's when he said 40 days. I think he didn't leave his house. Say?
I can't
remember. Isn't it Dalal? He didn't leave his house, something like that. Then he said, just making dua to Allah. Then I looked at Sophia. فده إلى الصوفية, you know, but you know, so we have to learn. That's my advice, أخوة. Learn, especially the books of Ibn Taymiyyah, Ibn Qayyim, رحمهم الله. Ibn Taymiyyah, Ibn Qayyim, رحمهم الله. أخي, they are a bridge between us and the Salaf. Salih. You know, like I remember like today, أخي, the brother that was in the argument, he said, okay, if you say God is limitless, I think he used limitless. He said, okay, it's God inside the tree. The brother said, no, I'm not talking about, it's on YouTube, it's still there. He said, no, I'm not talking about God. So, what are you talking about? Necessary being. Like, is the Quran argument, it's not the Quran argument. The Quran argument is so powerful, and it's so easy to understand, and simple, you understand? But some people say they're like complicated. Complicated stuff, to refute them, for example now, there's two tough ways to refute Darwinian evolution. General, some people, general way, say, okay, is it scientifically proven? Yes. Okay. Define science. Scientific method. Observation, collection of data, through experimentation, then you come to a conclusion. Okay. Give me a living example when we see one species evolve to a completely different species. This person, that will suffice him. But some people know you have to be so go in details with the, to suffice him. There's no harm with that. As long as you don't say stuff that go against Quran and Sunnah. And if you say no one is perfect, all of us, maybe happen to us, make tawbah. Not you start insisting upon the accusing people of zina, stealing money, lying against people, mocking a brother, say, you keep writing books, PDFs about me, your wife's waiting for you in bed. That's what the brother said. He said to a brother who is three times older than him, he said, your brother, your wife waiting for you in bed, go back to bed, do something. That's how you speak to someone, that's no ilm, akhi. That's no ilm. And not anyone that refutes malahida, or Christians, خلاص. No, ya akhi, what is your aqidah, my brother? What is your manhaj? The time of Imam Ahmad al-Hanbal, Jabir Mustafa was known to refute who? Atheist. In India. Imam Ahmad, he said, MashaAllah, he's refuting malahida. Refute him, akhi. Batil, la yansur batil. Al-batil yuraddu alayhi bilhaq al-mubin. Imam Ahmad was in Baghdad. In Baghdad, there was a Jewish people, Christians. He didn't say to the Muslims, shh, keep quiet, we should not refute each other. Because we're Jewish people, are going to laugh at us. No? Laugh or don't laugh. They should laugh at themselves. Because we are preserving our deen. And we show you that we are honest and truthful. We refute even the Muslims for the sake of protecting Islam. Allahu Akbar. That's what the Salaf, rahimahum Allah, Imam Ahmad, rahimahu ta'ala, Imam Shafi, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Shafi, rahimahu ta'ala, said, my fatwa concerning Ahl Kalam is to hit them and get them on a donkey and take them around and say that that is the outcome of anyone that live Quran and Sunnah and follow ilm al-kalam. Kalam Aristotelis. Imam Shafi'i said the people, they were okay when they followed the Arabic language. When they start following the lugha of Aristotle, they become corrupted. Timeless, spaceless, motionless, you know, limitless. All of this. Anyway, I have a class. You know, many videos I say I have class. People they make work. Yeah, I really have to go. You know, is that clear? May Allah bless you. Where are you from, brother?
Palestine.
Palestine? Hey, what's going on today? Too many Palestinians here, man. You know, Palestinians. You know, there was a nice book was written by one of the Katira from Palestine. It's Manhaj al-Falasifa fi Itbat. So he wrote three books. One book called Manhaj al-Salaf fi Itbat Wujud Allah wa Wahdaniyatih. He's from Gaza. Harar Allah Gaza. Munasar Allah al-Muslimina fi Palestine. على أعدائهم أن يرؤى أبوك منهج الفلاسفة في إثبات وجود الله أن يرؤى أبوك منهج أهل الكلام في إثبات very nice book. It's a doctorate. أخي ها I forgot his name سبحان الله but it's very nice book ما شاء الله. So what he does, he brings أقوال and he brings كلام ابن تيمية ابن القيم ابن تيمية ابن ابن الوزير because ابن الوزير رؤى book called انتصار. It's a nice book. أهل القرآن على أتباع اليونان. ابن الوزير. A nice book as well. Yeah. It's a nice book, أخي. So right, أخي. So الحمد لله, أخي. We love our brothers to see them refute some people of battle, but with the truth, أخي. No, not spreading جهنم بنصف وان عقيدة. المعتزز عقيدة and he wants me to keep quiet. No, that doesn't work like that, brother. وصلى الله إمامنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وسلم تسليما كثيرا. إخوة, I'm in Fugaya. You know, who knows a prostate prophet? He's a khabith, dirty, disgusting guy. You know him, eh? Some call him a prostate prophet. He's an evil, disgusting, dirty guy, yeah? But, brother, when you want to refute debate, especially if openly, for the whole world, there's a way to do it. There's a brother from America, he debated him, he finished him, mashallah. Even though I don't agree with this brother, because he said, like, Saudi put some ulama in prison. I don't know which ulama that they put in prison, according to my knowledge. You know, you see, some brother say, good, mashallah, in one particular thing. He finished him anyway. He, mashallah, did. But what I liked about the brother, he knows how to deal with it. Because he knows that, even me, I need to learn that. Brother Anwar is good like that. You know, Anwar, Irish Anwar, he's good. Keep calm. Me, Jazairi, you know, get angry quick. Passion. You know, frustrated.
Passion,
my brother, you know. And the people misunderstand me.
Yeah, yeah.
They think I'm angry, I'm gonna. But, you know, keep calm. And that brother, he does it. Like Anwar, he keep calm. So the people can see clearly, even if he's clear enemy of Islam. He is Adur Rahman, which he is. Like Khabith. May Allah deal with him. You know, may Allah guide him or break his back, you know, and burn his tongue. That's what makes du'a angas al-kaddab al-khabith. However, when you do open debate, thousands of people watching it, not knowing the hikmah. And there's many debates with some people, even they are enemies, you have to use hikmah. Not because you respect him. No. He's a khabith, adu al-rahman. Because you're going to utilize him to show the people, look how foolish these guys believe, but in a good way. And that's what the brother did. That brother debated him in America. The brother Daniel. That's what he did. He was very calm, and you can see my man getting angry. Khabith, Kaddar. But what happened yesterday? A brother sent it to me. I didn't watch it. Brother said to me, after I watched it, he said, watch it, please watch it. Akhi, that guy's Khabith. And the other brother is my Muslim brother. That guy's Dajjal. Because they all say, oh, he's a good kuffar. No. But akhi, it was embarrassment. I'll tell you this. والله والذي لا إله غيره ولا رب سوى was embarrassment. That even Muslims, that even some non-Muslims, and me myself, in the speaker's corner, sometimes I used to debate with some people and I get angry because he's like, I do. Then I regret it. You know why? Not because I regret it because of him. Because I remember how people watching. You know this man is khabith, but there's many people who are watching from non-Muslims don't know that. So it's a time for me now to be calm and refute him. And that's why I need to work on myself. People say, Shamsi, you have patience. I said, no, I don't know who you've been watching. I don't have, ikhwa, wallah, and I'm not calm. Sometimes in some debate, I'm calm, but I need to fix myself more. This is one of my mistakes. I got frustrated quick. But, you know, what do you think, ikhwa? You don't watch it? Some of you watch it?
Yeah.
We have to speak for Allah. What do you think?
Bad.
It was bad, akhi. It's not Madkhali, by the way. Yeah? People say, it's Madkhali. You know, because everything Madkhali. You know, but akhi, wallahi, wa billahi. What's Allah, الذي لا إله غيره والذي يعلم خائنة الأعين وما تخفي الصدور والذي يجمعنا يوم القيامة يوم التغاب يوم الحاقة. That was embarrassment. That guy's khabith, kaddab, dajjal, prophet, prophet. But if you don't know how to do it, people leave it. Me personally, I can't deal with this guy. Me as well, I go majnoon. I can't deal with people like that. You know, like, have you watched my video, for example, the video with the Zionist guy about Palestine? I don't know if you've seen it. I can't speak to people like that. I can't speak to people going to lie to me that they have a right to take Palestine. I can't do it. I got angry, you know. But after I said, no, I shouldn't have done that. I should calm myself and refute him. Even some people liked it. You know, especially the Arab, you know,
You refuted him well.
Alhamdulillah.
Well, you know.
No, but what, it was more for non-Muslims.
Even when you said you did it religious and secular, in every way,
yeah.
There was no way Israel...
Alhamdulillah, you know what I tried to do? When he said, shake my hand, I said, no. Because I will not shake a hand with a man that support these terrorists that kill my brother and sister Palestine. Never. You know? So I said, no. I said, look. Then I said, he said, because I'm not a Muslim. I said, no. There's many non-Muslims, I shake the hands. So look how evil guy twist it on me.
Yeah.
That because I believe he's dirty or something. No, I don't believe that. You know, alhamdulillah. So that's why, akhi, absolutely the truth. I should have calmed myself down, you know. But you know, akhi, some people, I told Anwar, there's some people, they need to speak to you, not to me. But I need to fix myself. Yeah, you know, I'm not saying I have the best manners. Sometimes my manners is very bad, Allah. May Allah forgive me. Barakallah, ikhwa. May Allah bless you all. Alhamdulillah, love you, groove me. Because some people say, oh, because you anger. No, wallah, ikhwa. A brother sent it to me and I watched it. I said, nah, no, this is not, I can't believe what I'm watching. Akhi, the guy said, mubahala, then he said, I tricked you because you're kafir. But the worst thing, he's a kafir, and he said, I don't care. I will do mubahala. To show you that he's, that's what he's doing. Wal'iyadu billah, he's mocking Allah. That's why the anger is coming from this khabir. Because he knows to mock Allah and his messenger. And you tell him, do mubahala. Look how he's mocking, he's doing like this. He's mocking him, and you're telling him, oh, you don't know. He's mocking him, my brother. Why are you making this foolishness? But they say, no, you work with the non-Muslims against the Muslims. That's what I'm going to say. Anyone that says Shamsi is with the non-Muslims against the Muslims, I challenge you. Come to the masjid, any masjid you want, with the mubahala. Today I'm on mubahala today. Come and do mubahala. Because this some issues, not a joke. When you accuse people. Mubahala that you claim that I, even though there's some mubahala, you don't, but I'm just get excited sometimes. But you know, Kusha Fawza said mubahala is not for everything. But I'm saying, if you claim that and you believe that, come and do la'na on us, that Shamsi works with the non-Muslims and gets the Muslims. No. Yes, if a Muslim, that's when we make it clear, if a Muslim is going to kill innocent people, I'll try to stop him, and I know he's going to kill me and kill more, I will work with a non-Muslim against him. Because why? This guy, I love him for the sake of Allah, but he's going to make Allah, now he's going to make Allah look bad, wa'iyadu billah, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us to kill innocent people that have nothing to do to us. That's what he's doing with actions, so I have to stop him. You understand?
Yeah.
Because why this guy, no, no, she's going to kill non-Muslims, he's going to kill Muslims too. The Khawarij do not discriminate. So they make that clear as well. And I'm not shy of that. And alhamdulillah, wallahi, I never took a penny from any country to spy on my brothers and sisters. Never. And anyone claim that, may Allah curse him. Alhamdulillah. And I'm excited today, too much coffee maybe. But alhamdulillah, I have to make that clear. Why, ikhwah, do you know why? Because some people, when they notice our da'wah is spreading, they say, okay, they're Salafis, people lie against them. I met Shamsi, he's a good brother, humble. I'm not the best humble anyway, but I try my best. Anyway, they say, look. Oh, they say, no, no, Shamsi, he works with the non-Muslims against the Muslims. You know? So I'm clarifying that too. So those Muslims are sincere seeking the truth. Barakallahu fikum, ikhwa. Subhanakallah, bihamdik, shalwa la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Wa sallallahu ala imamina wa qurrati a'ina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in wa salam salima kathira. Why is Mike? I said, take one, take Mike, brother. Qasimu fi sabilillah. Akhwa, who's Mike? I have to go home, man. Akhwa, you know, subhanAllah, speaker's corner become like Mecca, mashallah. In a way, I'm not on everything. You know, Mecca, you leave your staff, no one take it. Mashallah, speaker's corner, people leave their cameras, they go. Mashallah, no one take it. How do we take it, man? I'm Algerian. Astaghfirullah, that's me, Algeria, we're still here. We're not still here. I'm joking. May Allah bless you. You know, that's what we know, Akhwa. Once I got arrested by a police officer a long time ago, Jahiliya. He said, where are you from? I said, I'm Algerian. You know what he said to me? He's a bloody racist, man. He said, did you go to school to teach you how to steal? He said, well, how come all Algerians do pickpockets? I don't know why, but to my people, man. We used to be fatihun. Now we become mujrimun.